Greetings YouTube, this is Toy Customizer Wake Angel 2001. It's the day after Easter, so you know what that means. Time to go to Kmart and pick up the Easter baskets at 50% off. This is one of their big $20 baskets, which I got for $10. And it comes with a bunch of knockoff Transformers, along with 5 packs of candy. So, let's get right into this. Take off this tape. So yes, $10 yields you 2 packs of Airheads, some M&Ms, some Wonka Fun Dip, and some Lemonheads. It also gets you, it also gets you 3 airplane Transformers and a helicopter, and 1 really huge one. This thing looks like almost leader size, actually, even though, given the artwork on the box, it's probably an old G1 mold. But we're gonna find out together as I do something rare and actually do an opening. Let's see, what else is in the basket besides candy? Just a bunch of tissue paper warmed up in the bottom to make it look more full than it actually is. Yeah, and they wanted $20 for this. Okay, so I think I'll leave Mr. Giant Plane for last. Gotta love the knockoff name. It's the Changeable Robot Sky Thunder. Made by Huawei Toys. Contains 10 pieces. So you get a helicopter, 3 planes, and some weapons. So this is just your ordinary little knockoff blister pack. Okay. Yeah. Yep. Just an ordinary little blister packet. Has the instructions printed on the side. Put this aside. Alright, let's get my scissors out of the way and get a nice close-up look at these little cheapo toys. Alright, so here is the weapons tray. You come with a scythe, a sword, a trident thingy. This looks like a spare missile for the helicopter, and this looks like a halberd or partisan or spear or something, and a gun. That's actually a nicely varied little pack. Almost any kind of weapon you can name. Okay, I will leave. The planes have different looks, but are all basically the same mold. I think I'll leave them for last. Let us start with the helicopter. The blade, it does. Wow, that blade kind of sucks. It spins, but as you can see, spinning it can cause it to fall out. Distributed by Megatoys. Oh, they have a website, megatoys.com. Yeah, I mean, that's good when. I don't know what it says for a knockoff toy that it actually addresses the company that makes it. Like, yes, here's your little knockoff toy that is so cheap that it's not even sold in 99-cent stores. So we pack it in on little Easter baskets that we sell at Kmart for a few weeks out of the year. Okay, so since the instructions are on the blister card, let's see. It's a decent little looking helicopter, maybe a little bit blocky. Has really giant missile pods hanging off the sides. I don't know, for its size, it's probably not too inaccurate to what a big helicopter would look like. Okay, so transforming these guys is pretty simple. You just open that up and that's the robot. Wow. If this thing is This thing must be like G1 or something. It has a mono leg. It has a one step transformation. I mean, you can fold the helicopter tail down. That means that the blades can't spin, but wow. This is a really, that's the sticker. Yeah, like they can't even have the decency to put on a logo sticker in an area that comes off easy. I'm gonna have to wash the glue off. That's not a decal sticker. That was when I read the company name. That's where it was printed. Okay, so he has missiles. The missiles are on a pressure firing system. You may know pressure firing systems. Like there's a ball in there, and when I push on the back, of course, it totally doesn't work because the missile's too long. There's too much friction in there. Yeah. Wow, what a spectacular failure on the firing missile gimmick. Oh, plus the fact that since the balls are put in this way, that means the arms can't go down to his sides. Oh, you know what? There. I fixed it. Now his arms can go to his sides. Wow. Yeah, you do not get this guy for the helicopter. Alright, so let's get the fail-o-copter out of the way. Alright, let's take a look at these airplanes. I wish I knew military jets by heart. I do not. Hold on, these things look a little bit mistransformed. Just a second. Now, looking at this, it looks like there are a lot of places where parts are supposed to peg in, yet they don't. So it just kind of rests everything against itself at the bottom. So, this is that kind of airplane that has, adjustable wings that would blaze straight out for low speeds and sweep back like this for high speed. Let's transform them, see what we get. Well, already we have an improvement over the helicopter in that it has two legs. Let's see, the instructions say, oh, look at that, you just kind of flip it over. Okay, and there we go. Nothing really clips into place. He has a truly embarrassing little face sculpt there. Actually, articulation not bad. Good ball jointed shoulders, ball jointed elbows, ball jointed hips and knees. Oh. Actually, in terms of articulation, this guy is not bad. I mean, the plastic quality feels kind of cheap, but yeah, as far as articulation goes, he's pretty okay. Yeah. All right. Not the best little guy in the world, but certainly not the worst by far. I've seen far, far worse knockoff Transformer toys. So yeah. There you go. This little guy has a modicum of success. Okay, on to this guy. He has some kind of delta formation thing going on. Feeling him, he already feels much more sturdy. This guy, he feels, the first one wanted to fall apart as I was holding him, but this one feels like it's pegged together much better. So let's transform this guy. Actually, the transformation pattern is remarkably identical. Actually, if I do that, it kind of looks like, oh my god, these things can gerwalk. Look, it's the walking airplane from Robotech. Yeah, Robotech. Remember Robotech? Look at that. Tell me that doesn't look like a gerwalk. That's perfect. That's kind of nifty that it can do that. Makes me wonder, are these truly Transformers or are they just Robotech toys? Okay, so this guy, right, on the first one, there's a little bit of pink painted into the visor, like they at least attempted to pick out his eyes. This one, aside from the cockpit window, there is no paint on the face, which is a shame, because it looks like they sculpted in a pretty nice helmet. Actually, he has a lot of nice little sculpted detail. Let's see, his feet are a little smaller, so it's a little harder to stand him up, but otherwise, the articulation's pretty much the same. Ball joints hit everything. There's no waist joint, and the head is just sculpted in there, but for a knockoff Transformer, that's not bad. Not bad at all. He's a little bit back heavy. There we go. Yeah, he's having a hard time standing on the slanted part of the stove. Alright, and the last one. This is the only plane I know by name. It's an F-22 Raptor. Which means that this mold that they're knocking off has to be less than 10 years old, because the F-22 Raptor has only been around since the... Okay, this thing has a really loose shoulder socket. Get in there, you're embarrassing me. There we go. Yes, I think... Oh my god, the elbow is just tighter than the shoulder. Yeah, I think it's supposed to go like this. I swear, these guys are assembled upside down. I think the left leg and right leg are swapped. I think that's why. Because it looks like that's not supposed to tab in. Alright, so let's lift him up, bring his head out, and yeah, again, nothing really tabs into place. It just kind of supports itself. And oh my god, stop doing that. I had to brace the shoulder. He has these gigantic things coming off the back of his elbows, which, because his wings are there, get in the way. So unless his arms are straight out, he can't really pose with his wings unless his arm is up. Yeah, there's your little knockoff guy. Yeah, I am now certain that the left and right legs were swapped. Let's see. Hold on. Let me see if I can. Everything's ball joints, so that means that you can just do that. Yeah, that definitely feels more natural as left and right legs. Yeah. Get your fist out of your torso. Okay, so that's not too bad. Not too bad at all. Now here's a special little treat for you. last week I was at a little mini comic convention and found a big bin of used Transformer toys, and I found this. I think it's the actual G2 toy. The dealer told me that it was a G2 Transformer. Didn't give me a specific name, but I'm pretty sure that this is the mold that these little knockoffs are based off of. Because if you look, the transformation pattern is actually extremely similar. It's just that everything pegs together much better, and he has fold-away landing gear, which is pretty cool. And plus there's the added flair of an extra twist there. So yeah, everything on this guy pegs in mightily and solid, but once there... Oh, by the way, he has no head. Like I said, it was a used toy bin, and his head, which apparently had a swivel joint when it was there, is missing. But, yeah, same size, same level of articulation. I'm pretty sure that they are specifically knocked off of this particular mold, which must have seen a lot of reuse. I mean, ideally, all you have to do is change the wing pattern and boom, you got a new kind of plane. So, there you go. Max, you gotta calm down. I'm shooting the video here. You just can't get professional behavior from a dog. Okay, so let's see the little wet. Hold on a moment. Sorry for the interruption. Which probably doesn't mean anything to you because I stopped the camera. Okay, let's see if he can hold these accessories they came with. Because they do have peg holes in their hands. So let's see. Oh yeah, what do you say? The weapons actually do fit in there. So yeah, there's another little win for you. They can actually hold on to their weapons. That's kind of nifty, isn't it? Yes, my little knockoff aerial bots actually can arm up. After seeing the Maisto Psycon and its embarrassing attempts to hold on to its weapons, seeing these guys actually have weapons that they look like they can effectively wield, that's pretty nice to see. As for the quality of the weapons themselves, they are decent. This really thin one feels kind of flimsy, but you know, they don't feel like they're going to snap and they don't feel like they're made of rubber. So, all told, not too shabby. Not bad at all. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. I spoke too soon. Clearly these weapons were not designed for the massive claw hands of white guy. Let's see, what about this crazy missile thing? Does this... Nope, white guy does not have anything that can peg into. But can the weapons peg into the actual toy? Oh, how about that? It's a little bit tight, but they do fit in there. So... yes, if you actually do have the official G2 Jetformer thing that this is based off of, know that it can wield these cheap little knockoff swords. Okay. So, the plastic quality is kind of cheap. They don't really peg together anywhere. And they feel like they want to fall apart sometimes. But overall, for knockoffs, you could do a lot worse. I mean, $10 for three of them with the added bonus of a helicopter and some huge dude? Not too shabby. Yeah, I don't know what to do with this guy. This guy's already falling apart on me. Yeah, the white one's really cheap. He can't hold the weapons, and his tail fins are already breaking. Which is a shame too, because he has the biggest and most stable feet. So he's the easiest one to stand. All right, let's clear all this out and move on to the big one.